Hello children, welcome to today's class of probability. In my previous video, I have solved the sums of exercise 15.1, question number 1 to 5. Today, let us see question number 6. Look here children, here is your question number 6. For this question number 6, you have to refer table 14.7 of chapter 14. In that, you have to see how many students obtain less than 20% in mathematics. Remember children, less than 20% is your first question. Second question is, how many obtain marks 60 and above? The marks should be 60 and more than 60. So this is your required table children. Here first question was the students scoring less than 20%. Means here second class interval is from 20 marks to 30 marks. Less than 20 means we will take 7. So number of chances by total chances. Hence 7 by 90 will be your first solution. Second solution is 60 marks and above. Means it may be 70 also and above 70 also. Hence 60 and above means you should add these two values, that is 15 plus 8. So when you add 15 plus 8 you will get 23. So number of chances by total chances becomes 23 by 90. So here is the solution for your question number 6 children. Total number of students were 90. Students scoring less than 20% were 7. So required probability is 7 by 90. Again the students who scoring 60 and above I showed in the table 15 plus 8 is 23. Hence the probability is 23 by 90. As both are prime numbers we can't cancel them. Here your next question is the students who like statistics and who dislike statistics. First of all you should find the total number of students. When you add 135 and 65 it becomes 200. Hence the students who like statistics is your first question. Hence the probability will be 135 by 200. Second, who does not like statistics is 65 by 200. So number of chances by total chances we are going to write children. Here the same I have written, total number of students I have added first, and liking statistics probability is 135 by 200. On cancellation you will get 27 by 40. Number of students who does not like statistics was 65. On cancellation you will get 13 by 40. So here is your next question 8, which you have to refer question number 2 of exercise 14.2. It was an ungrouped data question children. First of all we should make the table for that, and next let us solve the sum here. So this is your question number 2 of exercise 14.2. Here there are the 40 engineers. From their workplace how much distance they are traveling every day they have given. First I have grouped the data, later I have solved the sum. So this is your frequency distribution table for your question number 8 that I have referred from exercise 14.2 question number 2. I have grouped the data first here children using 5 class intervals. From 0 to 5 kilometers how many are walking? 5 members are walking. And 5 to 10 there are 11 members. 10 to 15 there are 11 members. Similar way I have grouped, and the total number of engineers are 40. So your first question was who are traveling less than 7 kilometers is there children. In my group data 0 to 5 kilometers there are already 5 members. I have to check for 7 kilometers. Come on, let us count and say. So here is your solution children. I have to write first total number of engineers, that is 40. Here they have already given total number of engineers as 40. Now number of engineers leaving less than 7 km from their workplace. So 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 workers are 7 km and less they have to walk children. Hence I should write here 9, and next probability is 9 by 40. So now your second question becomes more simple children. You have to calculate number of engineers leaving more than or equal to 7 kilometers from their place of work. means already we have calculated less than 7 kilometers. Now you have to calculate 7 and more than 7. Hence what you have to do here means total I know already it is 40. So in 40 I have to reduce 9 now. So 40 minus 9 I am going to do, children. Now on subtracting I will get 31. So 31 engineers are walking more than 7 kilometers from their workplace. Hence the required probability will be number of chances by total chances. Next question is number of engineers leaving within half kilometer from their workplace. So your third question was less than half kilometer. Can you check here, children? All are in round figures only. No numbers are in half kilometers. Since no chances of half kilometers means we should write number of chances as zero. Hence probability is also zero. Henceforth number of engineers with leaving within half kilometer from their place of work is zero. Now probability is number of chances by total chances. Zero by any number is zero again. So your 9th and 10th question is an activity question, children. You can solve in the class with the help of the class teachers here. Now coming to the 11th question, find the probability that any of these bags are random contains more than 5 kg. More than 5 kg means 4.97 will not come more than 5 kg. Hence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 bags are containing more than 5 kg of flour. Hence, we are going to write the probability. Total number of bags, how much is there? We will count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, total bags are 11. So, here is your solution, children. Number of bags is total in 11. But containing more than 5 kg, now we counted as 7. Hence the probability is 7 by 11. Here is your 12th question, children. For this you have to again refer question number 5 of exercise 14.2. I have already referred and made it in the form of a table. So, this is your required table, children. Here the ungrouped data has been grouped here. Now let us solve the solution. Here we have to find the probability 0.12 to 0.6. So here on tabulating I got 0.12 to 0.16 as 2. Hence total number of days is 30 and 0.12 to 0.16 is 2. 2 by 30 will be my solution. So on tabulation we got 0.12 to 0.16 as 2. Now total number of days was 30. Hence 2 by 30 on cancellation becomes 1 by 15. Your 13th question is you have to go for question number 1 of exercise 14.2 and you have to find the probability of group AB. So I have already tabulated for that question. So look here, AB group, how many children are there? 3 students are there. So 3 by total number of students, that is 3 by 30 will be your solution, children. So number of students having blood group AB was 3, just now I showed you in the table. Total number of students were 30. Hence the probability is 3 by 30. On cancellation you will get 1 by 10. This is the probability, children. Thank you. If you have any doubt, kindly contact me, children.